Today we're going to have a chat about a day before, with today's news saying that development on the game has ceased entirely. Originally my review was going to question if this could be called a scam by trying to give a balanced view, but lo and behold, those blokes at Fantastic have done a rug pull, saying no more patches are to come and that the game is what it is. The reason they say that is that the game had failed financially, even though it accrued $11 million. For those of you not in the know, a rug pull is a term used in the crypto world, where devs go on about their crypto coin like it's the dog swinging bollocks, only to do a vanishing act, leaving everyone's cash disappearing faster than a pint at last orders. So, how in the world can platforms like Steam keep us from getting proper mugged off in the future? And what about the poor sods who've been left holding their bags here with a digital game sitting silently in their Steam library? Well, grab yourself a cutter and let's have a chat and more in today's video. Things changed quickly as I pulled this review together, but I did want to address the latest news of the developers scampering off and dropping the project altogether. So the first half is a mini review of the car crash of a game, and the second half talks around some of the issues that we now face with this rug pull, even if you yourself haven't bought the game. The day before opens up with the character creation malarkey. Not the worst I've seen, not the best either. It's all preset nonsense and reminded me a bit of the Ubisoft games from the likes of Breakpoint. I thought though, it's all right. It's early doors, they'll spruce it up in time, just give them a chance. As of now, all you can do is pick what can only be described as some sort of midlife crisis millennial who's invested his life savings into Dogecoin. But I did get moister when I had to pick my server and it stated that the population on each was high, meaning I should be good for some proper massive multiplayer online antics. The game's description. Turns out it ain't talking about the number of players, instead it's telling you how high folks must be to splash the cash and give this game a whirl, because you have to be higher than a kite. Eventually you get chucked into this tiny cutscene where you're told that someone from the surviving community swooped in to save your sorry ass from the zombie infection. Off you trot out the doctor's office and suddenly you find yourself in the main game hub, rubbing shoulders with other players. Then the game's like, oi, pay attention, and starts throwing slow motion camera shots at you, explaining the basics of the game. Now, I've half-assed a few things in my time, but this is the Wish.com version of The Division. No fancy introductions here, just collecting gear and scratching your balls over some build mode that's more baffling than a Cockney rhyming slang dictionary. I spent a good 20 minutes wandering around like a lost child in IKEA, figuring out how to patch myself up and where the fuck I was supposed to go. But given the benefit of the doubt, I thought, early access, right? Game's gonna bounce back from this nonsense. Well, all my hopes flew out the window as I stepped into the open world for the very first time. What becomes apparent is how empty this world is. It's like walking through a ghost town with nothing but tumbleweeds. There wasn't a single zombie in sight, not one bloody thing. This so-called high population server is as dead as a dodo, a city-sized wasteland with all the life of a desert. It's like they chucked in some game assets and hoped it would magically come to life. Spoiler alert, it didn't. Now, when a zombie finally decides to make an entrance, you'd reckon it's time to leg it, not in the day before. Instead, you welcome them like an old mate popping round for a cup of tea, having a proper chat. You're just desperate for anything to happen in the game. Problem is, these zombies are about as threatening as a three-legged kitten. There's no backstory or explanation here either. The game's basically saying, you want lore on these zombies? Well, go f*** yourself. Zombies are slower than a pensioner on a stroll and they can't hit a barn door. I even thought, right, let's do a naked run and see if I can spice things up a bit. Guess what? Not a peep from the undead as I tried to complete a mission. It was like playing hide and seek with a blindfold on. It took me about 20 minutes to do my mission naked and I never once come across an enemy. I did, however, run into other players, which was like stumbling upon a bunch of hungry seagulls eyeing up your fish and chips. These poor lost souls, they ain't looking for teammates or building communities. No, instead it's a straight up shoot first, ask questions never American police style. You turn a corner and bam, bullets are entering your naked body. And I can't blame them either. They've probably been sitting there for hours, starving for a bit of action, desperate for any sign of life. So the gameplay mechanics are a proper shambles. No vaulting, animations as stiff as Ron Jeremy in a cheerleader's locker room, and looting is like playing pin the towel on the donkey blindfolded. No cues for you, no hints, just luck of the draw in randomly going up to cars and pressing the interact button. Guns might as well be shooting peas. is, and the story, pathetic. Everyone who has played this game is calling it an extraction shooter, and they ain't wrong. You traipse around the map, pick up some bits and bobs for a mission giver, then leg it back to the hub. Sounds grand in theory, assuming the place is littered with zombies, but in reality, it's like watching a car crash in slow motion, except you are in the driver's seat. It's beyond abysmal. Graphically, this is as stale as last week's bread, and get this, some clever clogs on Reddit have showed that these assets are bought off other artists. Now, I ain't saying it's a scam based on that alone, but it's like they grabbed a bunch of Lego blocks from different sets and hoped it would pass for a proper building. This lack of personality ain't just in the streets. However, I stumbled on more problems. Poor optimization, leaving my high-end rig coughing and sputtering along, game bugs where you'd fall through the floor, and I can't even switch the resolution to 4K. Mind you, I've seen these hiccups in other early access gigs, so again, I don't want to come across too hypocritical here, because the day before isn't the only one that's doing it. As for the sound, drab as a rainy Monday, average voice acting, strutting about like it's the big cheese with a script that's worse than a soggy biscuit. And yes, I mean the soggy biscuit that you play at private schools. Jumping sounds like a sack of potatoes hitting the floor, but credit where it's due, distant gunfire echoes off to the sides, which can add some much needed atmosphere. Still, it's all a bit shit. So yes, this gets a 1 out of 10 score, and that's being polite. But there's no satisfaction here. Reviews like this aren't supposed to be fun or enlightening. A 1 score is a depressing state of affairs, and that's because it makes the hobby that we love so dear look so average. So let's talk about the abrupt fallout. Normally I like to give a game a proper go before I start slinging my opinions around, but the day before was such a bloody shambles, I was straight onto Steam and got my refund request in quick. But what about them poor souls who thought this mess had a future? They stuck past the 2-hour mark. They are the loyal ones, the ones who watched in anticipation from afar. Well, it's early access, and so by the book, they're in a right pickle. Steam refunds might be the saviour, but that's treading on eggshells for Gabe and his mates, because if Steam starts refunding abandoned early access titles, it's a slippery slope longer term. What about the other poor sods playing other early access games left in the lurch by their devs? Does that mean everyone gets a refund no matter how much they've dabbled in a game when it's already been abandoned? Gabe's got a proper tricky one on his plate here. Latest I'm hearing is that the game has been pulled and refunds are coming, but I've seen other Reddit forums saying this is simply not true and their refunds got denied, so I'm honestly not sure who is right here. For me though, this whole gig was a proper rug pull from the get-go. Look at the flashy marketing videos, the constant blabber from Fantastic about their roadmap. This was all part of a wider plan. They were asking for forgiveness well before the grand reveal, probably because they knew the community was sniffing around like a bunch of nosy coppers and working out that all was not what it seemed. Sadly though, they pulled the wool over the eyes of many unsuspecting punters. No clue on the final sales, but Game Sensor reckons 400,000 folks fell for it, dishing out $11 million to developers. That's a chunky payday. Even after slicing it up for taxes, the cut from Steam, salaries and server hosting, I can't deny it, Fantastic pulled off a masterclass in marketing, like they've been sipping on some genius juice from Don Draper himself. 400,000 people got duped, and that's a proper shame, but can we really blame the poor sods who fell for the allure of the day before? I mean, Ubisoft's got a PhD in downgrading games from their trailer, but the day before trailers, they are batshit crazy. The day before looks like a love child of The Last of Us and The Division, and in that alpha stage, who wouldn't think this game's got a bit of magic up its sleeve? No wonder it's shot up to be Steam's most wishlisted game. But the trailers, they were a pack of lies. As you saw in the review, it plays nothing like those snippets of Paradise. We're talking proper deception here, and there ought to be a law against this sort of thing. Early access might be their shield, but it's a shame when the trailers are more fictional than a Dickens novel. So what about the future? How do we put a stop to these rug pulls? When does early access turn into a proper scam. It's a head scratcher, and when you start going down the path and asking a lot of questions, you don't really have a lot of answers. I'm no expert on Steam contracts, but in my book, there should be some rules of engagement here. A guaranteed development cycle, maybe 6 months of TLC after launch before the full pot of revenue is handed over to developers. You can't have teams vanishing into the sunset 4 days after raking in $11 million. The industry needs a reality check, with publishers and devs joining forces together, saying this ain't a good look for our industry. Early access is a wonderful thing, and I for one think it brings so much good to our industry, but it's time for a bit of self-regulation, because Fantastic's shown they can pull off a fast one, and they won't be the last. No one's saying game development's a walk in the park, but when a mob pulls a stunt like this, it's downright disgraceful. The ripples from this will stretch far and wide, and I doubt this is the end of the story. The game industry is a tough old bird, and it's time to recognise the damage that can be done from one dodgy episode like this. But we can't let greed and self-centeredness run the show. Until next time, my lovelies, Reggie out.